In this video, we'll learn how to use state machines in p5js. State machine is a technical term from computer science for a program or a system that has a set number of modes where different operations happen. The full term is actually finite state machine, and you're already familiar with a very common state machine in the form of a light switch. Most light switches have two states, on and off, which determine whether power flows to an outlet or a light. We can apply a similar idea to code, where a state machine gives us different sets of behaviors within the same program. For example, in a PDF reader, jumping from one page to another allows you to see different states of a document. A video game with levels is also a great example of a state machine. In terms of creative coding, state machines are great for making programs with sequences of different visuals, animations, or interactions all in the same sketch. You could think of the states in a state machine like the pages in a novel, or levels in a video game. You probably already know from examples like these that there are different rules and structures for the way a viewer is allowed to move through the different states. Many old-school video games like Super Mario Bros., for example, are structured as linear sequences, where we start at a beginning state, moving one after another till the end. We could also look at some nonlinear examples like a branching sequence. You know this structure if you've ever read a choose-your-own-adventure-style book or played games where early choices affect final outcomes, like Bioshock, Breath of the Wild, or Dungeons & Dragons. Maybe at the beginning, you're presented with two choices. Depending on which direction you go, you'll then get different end stages. We can also create a state machine that's nonlinear in a random way, where we can jump from one state to any of the other states freely. If you've ever flipped through titles on Netflix or played open-world games like Minecraft, you've experienced this. Let's jump into our P5 web editor and set up a very simple state machine. First, I'll declare a new variable to track the state of my program. I'll name it something descriptive like current state. I'm going to set this up as a number variable, but some people prefer to use strings because for them it's a little bit easier to understand. So you could set a string like home, or start or beginning. I prefer a more mathematical approach, so that's what I'll stick to, initializing it with zero. I'd like this code to have four states. Down in my draw block, I'll set up a conditional statement to determine the current state and show different things on the canvas for each one. I'll start with an if statement to test for whether current state is equal to zero. Then a block where I'll add some commands for that state later. After that, I'll add an else if statement to test if the current state is equal to 1, and a block for those commands. And I'll use the same exact structure for states 2 and 3. Now I'll fill in some different color and shape functions in each block to get different behaviors for each state. Maybe an unfilled triangle in state 0, and two ellipses filled with blue in state 1. Then in state 2, I'll draw three rectangles filled with white. And in state 3, I'll set a red fill and make an interactive ellipse centered on the mouse. I'll click play and notice I'm getting a triangle with no fill. So right now, only this first part of the conditional statement is being executed. That's because current state initializes at 0, but there's nothing in my code that changes the value, so none of those other conditionals can ever become true. To switch states, I'll set up an event function down below my draw block. I'll use keypressed, which runs anytime a key is pressed on the keyboard. In that block, I'll add the line current state equals current state plus 1. Now when I click anywhere on the keyboard, the value of that current state variable goes up, and that makes a different section of the conditional statement true each time I click. So in state 3, I've got my red circle that follows the mouse. Now when I hit the keyboard, I don't actually see anything because I don't have a conditional for 4, and none of the other ones can be true. So here I could either add an else statement down at the end of my conditional chain. Instead, I think I'll add a check in my keypress block to make sure that the current state variable stays in a range that makes sense for my code. So I'll add a conditional here. If current state ever goes above 3, I'll just set it back to 0. Now I can just loop through all of my different states. I'd also like my sketch to tell me exactly what state it's in at any given time. So I'll add a print function to my event block with the string current state in quotes. then a plus sign, then the variable current state. Now every time I hit a key, I'll see what state I'm in displayed in the console. Right now, we have a linear sequence state machine, but maybe I'd like a random sequence instead. I can do that just by changing the line in key pressed where I'm incrementing that current state variable. I'll comment that out and replace it with a random function. So what I'd like is a random whole number between 0 and 3. So I'll start my range at 0, and I'll actually set the max to 4, since random will return up to, but not including its maximum. So that gives us a floating point number, and we'll have to convert that into an integer or a whole number. To do that, we just wrap the whole random function in the int function. Now, anytime we hit a key, we'll jump to a random state. Okay, that's how to use state machines in p5js.